जब भी मैं लोगों से बात करता था, आई यूज्ड टू टेल देम आई एम अप्लाइंग टू आईवी लीग कॉलेजेस एंड मेरा 1480 स्कोर इज, दे यूज्ड टू बी लाइक हे यू नीड टू री अटेम्प्ट एसएटी because you need a 1500.
So hi guys, today we have a college applicant which you have never seen before. He applied to only one university, that also an Ivy League school, and got accepted and never had to apply for any other university. And that also with 100% scholarship. So hi Praneet, can you please introduce yourself?
Hi Tanur, thank you so much for inviting me here. And I'm glad that I'm able to talk to you guys about my college experience. So मैं प्रणित गुप्ता हूँ. मैं sophomore हूँ Dartmouth College में, which is in Hanover, New Hampshire. And I study economics and international relations there. And as Hanur said, it's like basically full scholarship.
Wow. So now let's talk about your background. So आपने 11th 12th में non-medical लिया था या फिर anything else?
Nah, I think I was non-medical. Like आपने बोला, I know like there are a lot of engineers or वो सब हैं. टिपिकल है कि डॉक्टर बनना है या फिर इंजीनियर बनना है, बट आई वाज एक्चुअली कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट एंड आई टुक कॉमर्स विद मैथमेटिक्स एंड पॉलिटिकल साइंस.
परफेक्ट. सो नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद योर जर्नी टू डार्टमाउथ. सो हु इंस्पायर्ड यू टू अप्लाई अब्रॉड? तो पहले से आप शुरू कर रहे थे लाइक टू अप्लाई अब्रॉड सिंस योर 9th ग्रेड और लाइक इट वाज सडन स्विच?
बिल्कुल भी नहीं. आई थिंक अगर मैं बात करूं व्हेन आई वाज इन 9th और 10th, तो मेरा बिल्कुल टिपिकल वो था लाइक आई मीन ऑल ऑफ अस नो दैट एक इंडियन बंदा जो एक बहुत अच्छी स्कूल में जा रहा है उसका एक एम्बिशन होता है या तो फिर डॉक्टर बनना है या तो फिर इंजीनियर बनना है, आईआईटी देना है और आईआईटी एग्जाम होकर बढ़िया एक बढ़िया नौकरी मिल जाएगी. तो आई थिंक वो था मेरा पूरा 9th 10th तक. बट आई वाज इनटू एमयूएनस एंड इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंसेस, सो आई हैड लाइक अ गुड सॉर्ट ऑफ एक्सपोजर टू पीपल हु वर अटेंडिंग सच बिग कॉलेजेस इन द यूएस. एंड आई थिंक द टर्निंग पॉइंट वाज मी गेटिंग इनवाइटेड टू अ यूएन कॉन्फ्रेंस इन द यूएस. एंड जब मैं वहां अमेरिका गया एंड मैंने बात की लोगों से जो ऑलरेडी इतने बड़े बड़े कॉलेजेस में पढ़ रहे थे लाइक प्रिंसटन, डार्टमाउथ, हार्वर्ड, येल, कॉर्नेल, एंड जब मैंने उनसे बात की और मैंने उनसे बात की उनके एजुकेशन सिस्टम के बारे में, उनका जो सपोर्ट सिस्टम होता है उस कॉलेज में, कैसे फाइनेंशियल एड मिलती है पूरी और आप सिर्फ वहाँ चले जाओ और आपको फुल स्कॉलरशिप देंगे अगर आपके पास काफी टैलेंट और काफी अचीवमेंट्स हैं. सो आई थिंक दैट इंस्पायर्ड मी लाइक अगर मैं यूएस जा सकता हूँ, मैं एक आईवी लीग और एक टॉप वर्ल्ड क्लास कॉलेज में एजुकेशन ले सकता हूँ एंड इफ माई क्रेडेंशियल्स आर गुड इनफ, कॉलेज मुझे पूरा पे करेगा एंड आई डोंट हैव टू पे एनीथिंग, then what's a better deal? Like, I think so that was my prime motivation. Like, 9th, 10th में तो नहीं था बिल्कुल. It was like, पक्का था PCM लेना है, engineering की exam देना है, engineer बनना है. But वो उसके बाद switch हुआ and then I kind of shifted into commerce and econ because I think वो मुझे ज्यादा time देता मेरी जो international applications है उनके लिए prepare करने के लिए, SAT subject test, main SAT scores, like, you know, other just writing essays because as we know, like, when we're applying to US colleges, essays is a big component and when I wrote my essays, my Common App essay was 17 drafts. So oh it God. Took a lot of time. So with PCM to nahi ho sakta. PCM to aap book subah se leke baithoge raat tak book hi dekhte rahoge. To wo possible hi nahi tha. So isliye I took commerce and econ and then kind of made my mind that yes, I need to go to US colleges and a top tier US college.
Yep, and a lot of students not know that non-medical, medical, commerce, sciences, humanities, it doesn't matter what you want to study in the US. Because even if you have taken commerce in India, you can still take computer science, biology, whatsoever you want to in US, you can pursue. And they offer you the best possible flexibility so you can change your major anytime, right?
Yeah, I think definitely. Wo bilkul sahi, like, when I applied, तो मुझे उनको कुछ बताना नहीं पड़ा था कि वो मुझे चार साल पूरा इकोनॉमिक्स पढ़ना है या चार साल इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन पढ़ना है. आई बेसिकली व्हेन आई अप्लाइड जो मेजर वाली फील्ड थी, आई जस्ट सेड आई एम अनडिसाइडेड, आई डोंट नो व्हाट आई एम गोना स्टडी. एंड इवन लाइक आई जस्ट डिक्लेयर्ड माई मेजर्स लिटरली लाइक वन मंथ बैक एंड आई सेड कॉलेज ओके आई एम मेजरिंग इन इकॉन एंड इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन. दैट्स लाइक पूरा डेढ़ साल बाद आफ्टर आई गॉट इनटू कॉलेज. सो यू सी देयर्स सो मच फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. लाइक आई कैन गो एज अ मेडिकल स्टूडेंट एंड एंड अप डूइंग इकोनॉमिक्स और आई कैन गो एज एन इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट एंड जस्ट स्टडी आर्ट्स. लाइक इट्स जस्ट सो फ्लेक्सिबल.
Wow. And let's talk about why you applied to only one university, because as the competition is increasing every day, students recommend ki aapko 10 ki jagah 20 universities mein apply karna chahiye so that chances increase. But why did you apply to only one university?
So वो बहुत कॉमन था. लाइक मैन आई टोल्ड पीपल दैट आई एम अप्लाइंग टू टू कॉलेजेस एंड टू कॉलेजेस विद एक्सेप्टेंस रेट्स बिलो 10%, एवरीबडी इज लाइक यू नो फूल, जस्ट डोंट अप्लाई टू टू कॉलेजेस, अप्लाई टू एटलीस्ट 20, अदरवाइज कोई स्कोप नहीं होगा तेरा. बट यू नो इंडिया हैज अ डिसेंट एजुकेशन सिस्टम एंड the key benefit of going to US, I think, lies in these such top tier colleges. Like, agar aap Harvard mein padh rahe hain ya Dartmouth mein padh rahe hain ya Princeton mein padh rahe hain ya Yale mein padh rahe hain, to us education ki value hai. But agar aap se koi low tier college mein, जहाँ आपका एडमिशन बिल्कुल भी डिफिकल्ट नहीं है, जो आपको कोई स्कॉलरशिप नहीं देने वाला, आप 2 करोड़ रुपए देंगे, 4 साल में आप पढ़ेंगे और वापस आएंगे, आई डोंट थिंक उसकी वर्थ है. लाइक 2 करोड़ रुपए में इंडिया में इन्वेस्ट करूंगा तो मैं कितना कुछ कर सकता हूँ. मुझे 4 साल की डिग्री लेने के लिए 2 करोड़ रुपए नहीं देने को इंडियन कॉलेज, मुझे देने 30 लाख रुपए, मैक्सिमम 30 लाख रुपए. 30 लाख रुपए बहुत कह रहा हूँ मैं. सो अगर वैसा कोई कॉलेज जो मुझे फुल स्कॉलरशिप नहीं दे सकता, और वैसा कोई कॉलेज जिसमें मार्जिनल रिटर्न्स मेरे यूएस जाने के, एंड जस्ट लाइक टू लीव माई फैमिली एंड मूव टू एन एंटायरली डिफरेंट कंट्री, एन एंटायरली डिफरेंट कल्चर, इट शुड हैव लाइक बिग बिग एडवांटेजेस. आई थिंक दैट वॉज ओनली द केस विद टॉप टियर कॉलेजेस. लाइक वही कॉलेजेस थे जो एक तो बहुत हाई स्टैंडर्ड था उनमें एजुकेशन का, एंड दोज वर द ओनली कॉलेजेस दैट कुड गिव मी फुल मनी टू अटेंड दैट कॉलेज.
Wow. So it definitely makes sense that you wanted to get into top tier colleges, especially Ivy Leagues, but why only Dartmouth?
So, yeah. So, I know this typical notion that jab aap log kisi bhi ek Indian family se baat karo, ke to all they know is like Harvard, Princeton or shayad Yale. They don't know about other Ivy League colleges. And I didn't know either, honestly. Like 10th tak, I had no idea what Dartmouth was. Like Dartmouth was, I had no clue what that college was like. पहली बार जब मैंने Dartmouth सुना था, मुझे लगा था कोई कोने में छोटा सा कॉलेज है, and I had no clue what it was. But जब मैंने बात की लोगों से, और मैंने, you know, I spoke to professors, I spoke to admission representatives, I searched online, I read about the college, there was one big difference. In a typical college, अगर आप कोई भी क्लास ले लोगे, so you will have one professor and 300 students. In Dartmouth, you still had that one professor who was like extremely talented, he was a Nobel laureate, he was like an extraordinary professor. You just had 30 kids, so you see the difference in the level of engagement. Like two classes, same kind of professors, but one class at 300 students and one class at 30 students. So Dartmouth is like a really, really small college, and you know, we're just so close to everybody that in a week you'll see everybody on campus, and still you'll see a new face every day. So it's like a really tightly knit community. We're like just 4,000 undergraduate kids. And if you see at other colleges, say like Cornell, Brown, Harvard, you're like thousands of them. So I didn't want to go to a college where I didn't get personal attention. I wanted to go to a college where I attend a lecture, the professor knows me. Like, agar maine class li mere professor ke saath, aur main usko ek saal baad email karun ki I have this question or I need help, he would know that, okay, I spoke to this Pranit Gupta and I know he's an econ major and I know he's from India. So utna level of engagement, I don't think any other college offers. It's just incredible.
So before we talk about how you made it to Dartmouth, your overall application profile, SAT score, etc., I want to clarify that Dartmouth is a NEET aware school. So if you apply for financial aid, then chances decrease, but they definitely give you based on family or parental income. So now tell us about your profile. What was unique in your profile that got you any, especially your SAT score?
So Dartmouth is need aware, and that basically means that agar do log hain and dono ki same profile hai academically and they have the same set of extracurricular activities, and one kid is like extra rich and wo sab kuch de sakta hai college ko jitna hone chahiye, and one kid needs like $200,000 in scholarship, and if the university admissions office is to make a decision, they would go with that student who can pay everything. So yeah, that was definitely a factor, and like that was another barrier to my admission in Dartmouth, and I'm glad I just made it through.
And maine suna hai, like for most of the Ivy Leagues, 1500 plus is a must have. Is that true?
Yes, I think jitne logo se maine baat ki thi, so I had a score of 1480, which is below 1500. So jab bhi main logo se baat karta tha, and I used to tell them I'm applying to Ivy League colleges and mera 1480 score is, they used to be like, hey, you need to reattempt SAT because you need a 1500. Like that's a min. You can't get into an Ivy League college without a 1500. And I was like, you know, that's the beauty of US admissions. Like they're holistic. So if like there are 5 components about your application, aapke academics देख रहे हैं, आपका extracurricular देख रहे हैं, आपका passion देख रहे हैं, आपके SAT scores देख रहे हैं, और अगर उनमें से सिर्फ एक कुछ component weak है और बाकी 4 बहुत strong है, so I don't think it would matter because they would still judge you on those 4 remaining components, because you can just have a bad day and your SAT score can just go down or something like that. That was definitely like, that's definitely what I've heard too, like 1500 plus for Ivy League colleges. But I don't think ST scores are a decision maker till you cross like bare minimum threshold, which I think is around, say, 1400 probably.
Wow. So if your SAT scores were below standard, then what was unique in your profile that stood you out for the application process?
Yeah, I think the base was my academic achievements. Like in class 10th, I had a 10 CGPA. 11th, maybe I did really well and I had like close to 95%. Wow. 12th midterm examinations, again, I had a 95%. So I think college saw that consistency, like 10 CGPA, 95% in class 11th, and then again a 95% in like class 12th midterm examination. There was like a consistent, excellent performance graph that was, that you could see. And I think that was a big factor. Then extracurriculars, I think many MUNs, you know, it's like a typical Indian international kid activity. You go to a lot of MUNs, you wear good clothes and eat good food and do some debating. So definitely many B cities MUNs I've done. I represented my school in like national level quizzes. I won trophies for them. I have debated at national levels, but I think the key factor was this conference, was a UN conference that I got invited in, and it was basically the UN Youth Assembly and the United Nations, jo apex body hai to maintain the world relations, which is headquartered in New York City. So har saal they invite 5 se 10 log from every 195 nations that are members. And वो लोग आते हैं, वो 5 से 10 लोग भेजते हैं, वो वर्ल्ड इश्यूज डिस्कस करते हैं, इश्यूज लाइक पॉवर्टी, इनइक्वालिटी, फीमेल एम्पावरमेंट, बॉर्डर इश्यूज, स्टफ लाइक दैट. दे डिस्कस दोस इश्यूज लाइक रिप्रेजेंटिंग द ओपिनियन ऑफ द यूथ. दे डिबेटेड फॉर लाइक 3 to 4 days, देन दे फॉर्म अ रेजोल्यूशन सेइंग कि ये हो सकता है, एंड वी हैव बी लाइक we conclude that this is what the world community can do to improve the situation, and then that's presented in the main general assembly. The main general assembly being the event that is attended by like all presidents and prime ministers of 195 member nations of the UN.
So Maan Li Aagi, you applied to one university and you didn't get in. So what were your future plans that if you hadn't got into Dartmouth, that's the only university you applied to?
So it was pretty clear. Matlab, as I told you, only 2 colleges were in consideration, Dartmouth and Harvard. So agar main Dartmouth mein nahi ghus pata early, so the plan was to apply Harvard in a regular decision. और अगर वो भी नहीं होता, सो इट वाज बेसिकली गोइंग टू इंडियन कॉलेजेस लाइक से अशोका यूनिवर्सिटी, ओपी जिंदल, और काइंड ऑफ गिविंग लाइक बिजनेस एग्जाम्स, और आई डोंट नो, डेफिनेटली आईआईटी वाज नॉट एन ऑप्शन बिकॉज़ आई वाज डूइंग साइंस इन 11th 12th. लाइक कॉलेजेस लाइक अशोका, ओपी जिंदल, एंड यू नो, यू डू हैव गुड लिबरल आर्ट्स कॉलेजेस इन इंडिया, एंड आई थिंक दोज वर द की ऑप्शंस इफ आई डिडंट गेट इनटू डार्टमाउथ और हार्वर्ड.
गॉट इट. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट योर एक्सपीरियंस एट डार्टमाउथ. सो in terms of education over there, what makes Dartmouth so unique, and do you think it was a worth it decision to go there?
Definitely. Like again, I think it was definitely worth it. I've already talked about ki bahut chota college hai, and you just see everybody once a week, and still you see a new face every day, and the kind of engagement that you have with professors. And again, like as I told you, like scholarship thi puri, so I didn't have any financial difficulties. Like if there was a college trip or which was going to say like, you know, Europe for like 30 days, that's basically free for me, because I know other kids were paying $10,000 for that trip, paying nothing for that trip. So it was so cool, like, you know, just kind of exploring different parts of the world through like learning experiences, and that was incredible. And professors, incredible. Like as I'm sure that's the case with every Ivy League college, but all professors are like experts in that field. Like for example, I took this class on nuclear weapons last semester, memory, and that professor basically consulted for US presidents on nuclear policy. Like he was the guy who was telling US president that, hey, this is what we need to do with this nuclear weapon in, say, XYZ country. And that was just incredible.
Perfect. So what will be some of the final tips you would like to give to students, that they should apply for one university and then wait and then apply to remaining universities, or like apply to 20, 50 universities altogether?
I don't think 20 to 50 universities is a rational choice. Like, and I definitely don't think applying to one university is either, because like mere liye said tha ki mujhe 100% scholarship chahiye thi and I wanted to go to a top tier college. Isliye I applied for 1 or 2 universities. But if you're like a student who's interested in studying in US and you can pay something, then I would recommend applying to like 5 to 10 universities, but not more than that. Because अगर आप 10 यूनिवर्सिटी में अप्लाई करें तो आपको एटलीस्ट 10 essays लिखने, और अगर आप 50 में करेंगे तो आपको 50 लिखना है. तो आप उनके लिए एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट करना पड़ेगा. इसलिए जो आप एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट करें वो आप उन 10 यूनिवर्सिटी की एप्लीकेशन पे करें और उनको बेहतर करें. आई थिंक दैट्स माई बिगेस्ट टिप, लाइक फोकस ऑन सम एप्लीकेशन एंड जस्ट मेक दम एक्सलेंट. लाइक डू वट एवर यू कैन टू राइट दैट वन एक्सलेंट essay that you'll submit to your dream college. And then I don't think there's any need to be demotivated by just anything. Like, theek hai, sabka bure din aate hain. Everybody has a bad SAT score once in a while. Everybody has a bad test. Everybody fails at something. So that should not be a decision maker to with respect to where you apply. Because again, us din agar mujhe maine logo ki baat maan li hoti ki 1480 enough nahi hai Ivy League college mein, to ना मैं आज एक आईवी लीग कॉलेज में पढ़ रहा होता और ना मुझे वो स्कॉलरशिप मिली होती. सो आई डोंट थिंक लाइक इफ यू हैव अ ड्रीम यू नो यू देयर इज अ ड्रीम कॉलेज यू वांट टू गो टू, आई थिंक मेक एवरी एफर्ट यू कैन टू गो देयर. आई मीन योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इज टू ट्राई. सक्सेस एंड फेलियर दैट्स नॉट इन योर हैंड्स. जस्ट ट्राई 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 एंड आई एम श्योर यू विल गेट समवेयर.
Wow. So without counseling, आपको कभी ऐसा लगा नहीं that I don't have mentorship, I don't have someone to check my answers from and stuff like that? कभी लगा नहीं ऐसा?
I think काफी resources हैं online. Like if you just do a quick Google search, like essays for Ivy League colleges, you'll get hundreds of links recommending you कि ऐसे लिख सकते हैं. This is what you should look for. Past essays, stuff like that. So I think there's a big chunk of online resources, and I don't think like spending thousands or even lakhs in some people's cases on like counselors and big these groups are just there for making money makes sense. I don't think it makes sense. The one advantage I had in my case was like I had some friends at like Vanderbilt, Harvard, and Penn who definitely reviewed my applications and gave me some input. So if you have those set of friends and you know there are 2 to 3 people who you can talk to and you trust them, आपको लगता है कि वो आपको सही advice देंगे and they will guide you, then I think counselor doesn't make sense. Like you'll have all the online resources and you just need some feedback on your essay, how you're writing your resume, how you're framing your activities list, stuff like that. So I think counselor isn't a must. Like it's okay if you take it, but it's not like agar aap counselor nahi loge to aap success nahi achieve kar sakte, aap ek acche college mein nahi ja sakte, aapko counselor chahiye. That's not the case, I think.
Amazing. So thank you so much, Praneeth, for sharing your valuable information, and I'm sure that this video is going to inspire thousands of students with less SAT or some sort of fear of applying to Ivy Leagues, and they will definitely get it. Thank you.
Definitely, Anil. Thank you so much for hosting me.
Perfect. Pleasure.